It's time for us to take our motivation segment this Monday. Now, in the studio, we have Mr. Fola Daniels Adelisi. Now, he is an international keynote speaker, training facilitator, and communications professional. He is the author of more than 12 published books on motivation. And today, he's going to be sharing with us this issue of reinventing and equipping ourselves. Welcome back to
the
show.
Thank you. My pleasure to be here.
It's great to have you.
You too.
All right. So reinvention, equipping, where do these fall in line with the average Nigerian?
Okay, the thing is sometimes we get stuck in our career, and there's something about psychological conditioning that I just heard. Well, it's been around for a while, and it was about the story of a frog, that if you put a frog in a hot water, it's going to jump out.
Yeah.
But if you put it in water and adjust the temperature gradually, it will stay there until it dies. Mm. And the reason it's going to stay there until it dies is that, first of all, its body does not sense that the temperature is adjusting, and the body gradually adjusts to the temperature. But if it was hot, it would jump out. So when you bring it back to human beings, most times, a lot of people cannot sense that things are moving out of their hands. It's like the story of Who Moved My Cheese. Mm. Have you read that book before?
I'm not complete. But
fantastic book. Yeah. Mm. So it's talking about opportunities moving from one point to the other, and people not knowing or not realizing that things are changing, the opportunities are moving away, and some of them are not going to come back. So there were these characters in the book, Who Moved My Cheese. They just kept hoping that the cheese would come back miraculously. They found a mass amount of cheese somewhere, and they kept eating and eating and eating until they ate everything. So there was no more cheese one morning when they got there. And they, instead of looking for another cheese station, they just kept hoping the cheese would come back. Human beings are also like that. We lose out of opportunities. The skills that we have are no longer relevant to our industries. The knowledge that we have are no longer relevant in the places where we've been using them. And we're just hoping that miraculously, things will change, our skills will become relevant again, our knowledge will become relevant again, or we're just going to keep making the money that we're making. But they don't realize what needs to change is either your skill, your knowledge, or your flexibility as well. So if you take a look at average Nigerian, just like you said, there are a few people who are reinventing themselves. In the movie industry today, it's Shola Shobowale, who's been around for years.
Yeah.
And she's come back with a big bang. And you think of RMD as well. Mm. In the music industry, you can think of maybe Owasio Ayinde. Today, you know, a lot of people don't like Fuji. But today when you hear, Emma Yonu See Me, everybody just... I've seen people who never liked Fuji, and they're singing that song because of the message in it. Yeah. In the business world as well, you realize that quite a number of people are coming up with new ideas, new innovation. So the idea of reinventing is to say, look, what you did 5 years ago is no longer working. And the global pandemic actually caused a huge disruption.
Of course.
So what are you going to do differently? A lot of people have lost their livelihood, and since the pandemic, they've not gotten back on their feet. Mm. So that's why we say you need to reinvent, you need to re-equip yourself.
So now let's think about steps and stages to reinventing. What are the aspects of life that we need to start from, and then how do we gradually get there?
Thankfully, we started last week with saying audit your relationships. Sure. So that's the first and the most important thing. Check the relationships around you. Okay. So from relationships, we move to knowledge. There are times when you need to go into a different field completely. Maybe you have to go back to school. Maybe you have to go and learn a new skill. Take, for example, there are some people who are into events and stuff like that.
Yes.
You know, if you're into events and you realize that events are not coming, but some other people are still getting events, what if you learned photography? What if you learned maybe live streaming, digital marketing and stuff like that? So if you don't get the event, you can get the business for the live streaming or for the digital marketing or photography. And photography is a lot of money these days. So you need to find something that makes you more relevant. If, for example, as an event manager, all you do is coordinate people, so a lay person can also do that without the training. But what else do you do? What extra touch do you have? Or what additional skill are you going to learn such that you are indispensable or nearly indispensable? Because there's no indispensable man. So it's going to be number one, people. Number two, skills. Number three, knowledge. Those three things will help you reinvent yourself. And you can do without them anytime, any day.
Okay, so we've touched on reinventing now. Now let's move towards the re-equipping.
Yeah.
So how, first of all, not a lot of people understand what it is to be equipped.
Yeah.
And how do we begin?
Let me use myself as an example. I'm into public speaking, and I do quite a number of trainings that are even outside of public speaking. So people ask me, how did you get to know all of these things? I said, what happened was, while I was looking for platforms to push what I do, what I say, or push my materials, I had to learn some of these things because outsourcing them was too expensive. So instead of outsourcing, I was learning. Today, the knowledge that I gathered has become a valuable asset for me. So if there is no speaking engagement, because sometimes you have gaps in between jobs, I simply switch over to some of those other things. So equipping yourself means that you actually have something that helps you make money.
Yeah.
You have something that keeps you going in life. So let's just put it that majorly something that helps you make money. So if you lose everything that you have today, you still have a skill that helps you make money.
It's so interesting you should mention that, because as at 5-6 years ago, I was having other people trade on my behalf. I'm talking about Forex trading now. And then eventually down the line, I started
doing it
learning
yourself.
And then eventually teaching. And then, you know, I've started teaching, and then I make money from that as well. But the issue is some people are really set in their ways. Okay. They've been given this cultural standard of you go to school, get a degree,
get a good
job, start a 9-to-5. And live on.
So this is the challenge with that. Sometimes we don't expect a life will happen, and life does happen. I've seen people lose their jobs unexpectedly. So if you don't have another skill, if you have not equipped yourself for something else, that person becomes stuck immediately. And imagine if you lose your job at the age of 50, where are you going to start from? If you lose your job at 45, where are you going to start from? So the person who loses a job at 25, at 35, has a higher chance of starting all over. They are more agile. They are more mobile. So it's important that you always have something. Maybe even if you're not doing a business on the side right now, have an extra skill that if you lose your job, you lose your livelihood, you can quickly get into that other thing. So it's very important.
So let's talk about some of the easiest life skills that we can equip ourselves with that can help us move into other fields.
Yeah. Okay, so I mentioned photography earlier.
Yes.
Today there's digital marketing. You talked about Forex. Mm-hmm. So you may want to consider there's interior decoration.
Yeah.
And guess what? With interior decoration, you can make a lot of money without lifting a finger.
Hmm.
The knowledge is what you need. It's almost like event management. You're bringing the guy who's doing the furniture. Yeah. You're bringing the guy who is sewing. Do you know there's another guy who don't let me say he sews. Mm-hmm. What he does is he gets a lot of people's materials, brings back a suit for them. But the guy does not know how to sew.
So he just goes to tailors.
All he knows is how to take your measurements. So he takes your measurements, makes sure he gets the details, and gives it to some tailors. But he will make it look like he's the one sewing it. And I've seen like two different... He's making a lot of money.
Wow.
Because he has his markup on whatever he gives to other people. So there are little things like that you can do. We said photography. Mm-hmm. We said event management. We said interior decoration. Yeah. There's also sewing.
Yeah.
And there are quite a number of other things like that. Then another way to reinvent, really, is go on the internet, go on alisten.com, go on coursera.com, go on edx.org. Yes. There are MOOC, they call them massive online open courses. You can check on, there's also Google Digital Skills. There are quite a number of skills that you can learn online, and they're all almost for free. For example, Alisten, you just have to pay for a certificate at the end of the day, but the training is free.
So, you know, it's so interesting. On LinkedIn, the job platform, it feels like, you know, there's so many different opportunities, so many different skills people are looking for. Yeah. And, that should give you a template as to what people need
exactly
in the world of today. Thank you so much.
My pleasure once again.
As always, it's been a very enlightening segment on Motivation Today. Please talk to us and use our hashtag WakeUpNigeria on TVC.